Good morning, class. Our topic for today is about the vapor compression system. Of refrigeration. So basically what we're going to discuss is how does the basic refrigeration cycle works. Okay, so I will draw the the basic components of the refrigeration cycle. First, the heart of the system is here at the compressor. Then we have here another component. This is the condenser. Here. And here is the expansion valve. Or the so-called TXV. It's a thermal expansion valve. And the other is here, which is the evaporator. Okay. So, these are the four components of the refrigeration system. Huh? So let me explain first the devices or the parts. These two, the condenser and the evaporator, is called heat exchanger. Heat exchanger. Meaning they are the machine that allows the transfer of heat, the exchange of heat now from higher to lower temperature. So the cycle goes like this. I mean, we're using another color. So here is the compressor. The refrigerant will be coming, yeah, on the suction line in a gas form, no, or vapor form. So, and it will be compressed to higher pressure. Yeah. Why higher pressure? Because this one, this side on the left side is low pressure side, and the other is high pressure side. No? If you are going to divide it vertically. So the low pressure refrigerant coming from the evaporator will go to the compressor and it will be compressed. Once you compress, the temperature will go up and the pressure will also go up. Then it will go inside or come to the condenser. So the condenser, the function of the condenser is to reject heat, heat rejection, while the function of the evaporator is heat addition, meaning this absorbs heat, right? This absorbs heat. The refrigerant absorbs heat. This one, it rejects heat. That's why at the back of your air conditioning system or at the back of your refrigerator, there's a hot air because that is where the condenser is mounted. So heat is rejected here and then heat is added here. Once the heat is rejected or displaced, the refrigerant is being cooled. Yeah? So the gas form of the refrigerant, once it goes through the coil of the condenser, it becomes liquid. Okay? Here the refrigerant is vapor. Here the refrigerant is condensed into liquid because heat is given off. Heat is being thrown into the atmosphere. Then it goes into the evaporator expansion valve because this one is still in the high pressure. Remember, this is high pressure side. the liquid form of refrigerant here is high pressure. So it goes into the expansion valve, and you may guess what is the function of the expansion valve. It lowers the pressure of the liquid refrigerant so that when it goes to the evaporator, it will have a low pressure. So the thermal expansion valve has a series of orifice. No? So when it passes here, it lowers the pressure, it lowers the temperature, because that is the function of the evaporator. At low pressure, at low temperature, it will absorb the heat from the surroundings. Okay? So where does the heat comes from? In the basic refrigerator, your refrigerator in the house, the heat comes from anywhere. When you are opening the door, the heat comes in, or the heat comes from the items being put inside the refrigerator, like the water, the meat, the vegetables. Yeah? So those heat from those items will be absorbed by the refrigerant. You know, the refrigerant is a special kind of chemicals or compound that is having a very low boiling point, even at the atmosphere, or even at the negative degree, it can boil, it can vaporize. So once it absorbs the heat from the meat, from the vegetables, from the water, from the environment, from the insulation, the refrigerant will go into form of gas. Now it will evaporate, because that's the function of the evaporator. And then again, the vapor will come here, and it will be compressed, and then it will go to the heat exchanger, which is the condenser. So this is gaseous state. Gaseous state. Gaseous state. And also here is like a mixture of a gas and liquid. Now there is still kind of mixture here, yeah, some percentage, yeah. But normally it will be ideal if here is the kind of vapor, yeah? In the evaporator, if it's a saturated gas, it will be better, because a liquid could not enter the compressor. It will break down the parts of the compressor. Only it should be in the vapor form that the compressor will compress the gas into higher temperature. Yeah. So now, how is heat? How is heat transfer put into effect here? And how does cooling comes in? No? So the cooling happens here in the evaporator. When you try to open the refrigerator, the one that is located in the freezer are the evaporator coils. Or when you look at the air conditioning system, the one that is being in front, yeah, the coil or the heat exchanger in front is the evaporator. At the backside, where heat is given off, that is the condenser. Okay? So the cooling happens here in the evaporator. Okay? So the liquid, the cool air will be fanned out. There's a fan here. Somewhere here, there's a fan that will that will blow the air, so that it will go out into the ducting. There's a separate ducting that will be installed here, and then it will, the cool air will come out. Now, how is the hot air in the surroundings cool off? Yeah. So the hot air is being sucked by the evaporator. Now, because this is heat added, the heat comes in here. Yeah. Heat comes in. So when you try to open your air conditioning, when you put a paper or something that is very thin, you can see it will be sucked off by those coils. You know? So all the air, all the heated air will be sucked by the evaporator. Yeah. So that also in the that will also evaporate the refrigerant inside the coil. Yeah. So the mass of air will be sucked here, and then it will evaporate the refrigerant, and the refrigerant will go to the compressor, and it will have a high temperature, high pressure. It goes to the condenser, which is heat exchanger. It will give off heat. It will throw heat into the environment so that it becomes liquid. You know, when you get the heated part, meaning you will have an absence of heat, it will become cool. Yeah. So it will become cool. It will cool down and it will go to the expansion valve. But it's still hot here. So because it's a high side, yeah, it's still high side here in the expansion valve. The pressure and the temperature will gradually come down, and then until it finally goes to the evaporator. So this is the cycle of vapor compression. Why vapor compression? Because the vapor of the refrigerant is being compressed, yeah? And thereby in the cycle it can heat, it can cool down the surroundings, like the room or the auditorium and so on. So that is the cycle of the vapor compression, which is the basic part of the refrigeration part. So this topic is under HVAC, which stands for heating, ventilating, air conditioning. So as you can see, heating is happening here, yeah? There's a transfer of heat in the evaporator. Also here, heat is given off. Yeah? Ventilating means you are changing the properties of air, like it's the humidity, it's pressure, temperature, and so on and so forth. Yeah? So that's why here is ventilation. And air conditioning, you're conditioning the status or the condition of the air so that it will produce comfort cooling. So that's it, the refrigeration cycle based on the vapor compression system. Thank you.